Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll be learning how to configure the shipping attributes into Google Merchant Center. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. One of the first things that you need to do is add the shipping information into WooCommerce. So I'm going to go to WooCommerce. Here, I'm going to click on Settings. When you're in Settings, you'll see all the different tabs. You want to click on Shipping. Once you've done that, to add a new shipping zone, click on this button. Now let's say the zone name, let's name this US. Let's say the region I'll be serving is California. So I'll choose that. Let's add another zone here. Let's say we're going to ship to Alabama as well. Now for the shipping method, we're not going to configure it right now. But before we configure the shipping methods, let's look into shipping classes. Here, we can add classes of the different kind of products that we have. To add a new shipping class, click on the button Add Shipping Class. Once you've done that, let's give it a name. Let's say the first class that we'll configure is for heavyweight. So let's say heavyweight order. Make sure you remember the slug because we need to configure this later on in the Google Merchant Center. There we go, we have the first one. Let's add a few more. Let's add another one, which is for light orders. So I'm going to change this to light. And we're going to add the slug right now. Underscore, and let's put in the same description as well. Let's add another class, which is for large quantities. Let's add that. This is for large quantities order. Let's fill in the slug as well. Once again, let's put in the description. Let's add a few more. This one is going to be for a large price order. Once again, let's fill in the slug. And let's say we have another one, which is for remote destinations. Let's go ahead and save all these classes. Once all the required shipping classes are configured, we can go back to our shipping zones and configure the prices. So I'm going to go into the shipping zone that we have created already. I'm going to click on edit. And now when you go to shipping method and you click on add shipping methods, you can add this rate. And here, when you go ahead and edit it, you'll be able to see all the different prices that you can configure for your shipping class. So right now, let's go ahead and configure these. Let's say for heavy prices, we're going to charge $20. For large price orders, because they're buying in bulk, we're going to give them a discount. Let's keep it at 10. For large quantities as well, let's put it to $12. For lightweight, because it's so small and light, let's just keep it at $5. And for remote destinations, since it's so far away, we're going to charge them a premium of $40. Let's keep no class shipping order as empty. We'll keep the calculation type at its default value, which is charge shipping for each shipping class individually. If we scroll up, we can see we have kept the cost at zero here. So if there's no classes assigned to a product, there's going to be no cost for shipping. Let's go save these changes. Now it's time to go to products and assign these classes to our products. Now we are in our product page. Let's go assign some classes. Let's go into magazine bulk. Let's scroll down, let's go to shipping, and this is where you can assign a shipping class to your product. So right now, because these are magazines and we're selling it in bulk, so I'm going to configure this as a heavyweight order. And let's say the weight is 20 kilos, which is perfect. Let's update it. Now let's go find another product. Let's say winter long sleeve hoodie. Let's scroll down. Under shipping, the weight is very low, which is only 200 grams. So let's give this lightweight order. Let's update this product as well. Now let's go find something for a large order. Let's say men's brief, 100 units. Let's use this as a large quantity order. So once again, you scroll down, find the shipping tab, and here I'm going to give this a large quantity order. Let's go update it. The next class we're looking at is for a high price. So let's say we've got these heels. These are Gucci, so they're very expensive. So let's make this a high price product. So under shipping class, let's go large price order. Let's update it. Last but not the least, let's set something up for remote destination. Let's say we are sending these V-neck t-shirts to a very far location. So let's go to shipping and configure this for remote destinations. Let's go update it. Now all our products are ready and set with different shipping classes. To make sure all this class information is correctly picked up, we have to configure a feed with the correct attributes. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and create a new feed. I'll keep the country at United States. The template would be for Google Shopping. The file name is for, let's say, shipping one. I'll keep everything as a default value. USD is fine as well. Let's scroll down. Let's give it a product category, apparel and accessories. Let's scroll down and add a new attribute. So the attribute we're looking for to pick up the shipping classes is shipping label. So let's see if I can find that. There we go. And here we'll add shipping classes. There we go, shipping class. Let's go update and generate this feed. Once the feed is ready, let's have a quick look and see if the shipping labels are being picked up correctly. There we go. When we scroll down, we can see shipping labels and it's picking it up. Now we are set and ready to go. Let's go ahead and upload these products into our Google Merchant Center. Right now the upload is complete. Let's take a look at the products. As you can see, all the 5 products seems to be coming through. Perfect. One of the image right here is pending. But that's okay because product data can take up to 30 minutes to update in the Google Merchant Center. Now it's time to go ahead and configure our shipping here. Go ahead and click on this icon. Under Tools, choose Shipping and Returns. Once you have done that, click on this little plus icon to add a new shipping service. Let's name this Shipping 1. The country that we'll be using is United States, keeping it consistent with our feed. Let's go next. Right now, I want to set the delivery times manually, so I'll choose this option. Set a range of deliverable times. Now you'll have all these options. Here, you can set the order cutoff time, which means if anything is ordered after the cutoff time, the order will be processed on the next day. So let's go select something, let's say 12 a.m. I'll just choose a random time zone here. The handling time is the time that you need to process an order. So let's say I'm going to need 1 to 2 days to do that. And you select Monday to Friday here. And the transit time is the number of possible days or duration it will take for the product to reach depending on the product nature and its destination and the region it will be sent to. So let's say I'm going to choose 2 to 3 days. I'm going to choose Monday to Friday again. Let's scroll down. If you want, you can add holiday shipping cutoff times. That means you need to order before a certain day for your products to reach for certain holidays. But for now, I'll just keep it at empty. Let's go next. Now you'll be presented with all these options. Let me explain all the different options that we have here. The first option that we have here is free shipping over a certain amount. That means after you have ordered a certain amount in price, the shipping cost will become free for you. Here you can set how much charge you'll be charging before the free shipping takes into effect. So for now, I'm going to choose for price below, let's say $100, I'm going to charge a $10 worth of shipping. So that's one of the options. If you want, you can choose that. The next option is free shipping. That means for any item or any price products that you're ordering, all your shipping is going to be free. The third option that you have is range based. Here you can add the different prices you'll charge for shipping for certain ranges. Let's say, for example, for 100, I'll charge, let's say, $10. If you want, you can add another range. Let's say anything from 100 to 200, you're going to charge a bit less, which is $5. And anything above, let's say 200, you will charge them $2 only. So this is another way you can add different prices for the different shipping arrangements that you will have. The fourth option that you have is a flat rate. When you choose a flat rate, it doesn't matter how much you have ordered, the destination, and the region you're sending it to. Everything will be charged the same amount. So let's say for all orders, the shipping is going to be $15. So this is another way you can set it up. Last but not the least, we have carrier. For certain countries, you have the option of using a carrier, and the shipping rate is going to be defined by the dimension of the product and the region it's sending it to. The price you'll also be charged also depends on the kind of carrier service you'll be choosing. Because we have used United States, you can see all the options available for United States. You've got UPS, you've got different services you can choose, you've got USPS, and you've got FedEx as well. But for now, since we have shipping labels configured, we'll be using this, which is Advanced Settings. Let's go ahead, click that, and see how we can configure it. Here, you can add different shipping rates. Moreover, you can also assign shipping label attributes to different shipping rates, and that is exactly what we'll do. Because previously, we have created a feed where we have our different shipping labels assigned to it. Let's go ahead and create a new one. Click on this little plus icon. Give it a name. Cool. And I'll filter the product by shipping labels. As you can see, we already have a product assigned under it. Here, if we scroll down, you can see the shipping rate table. And this is where you'll be assigning the rules on how they will be priced for their shipping. Let's go ahead and configure it for our weight. Now, before we add the order weight here, we need to ensure that we have correctly picked up the weight from our feed. So let's go back to our feed. Let's scroll down and check if we have the shipping weight configured here. As you can see, we don't. Let's go ahead and add a new attribute. What I'm looking for is shipping weight. There we go. And here we'll add the weight. Perfect. Let's update and generate this feed. Let's copy it. Now back in my Google Merchant Center, I'll go ahead and reprocess this feed. Alright, our product upload is complete. Let's go back to configuring our shipping rates. For our heavyweight product, we will be choosing this option, order weight. Let's click on that. Let's say weigh in kilograms. Let's say from 0.1 kilo to 10 kilos, the fixed rate is, let's say $10. But if it's heavier than 10 kilos, let's say we're going to charge them $20 instead. If you want, you can add more rows and dimensions, which is going to help you customize your shipping options even more. Let's try adding one more. Let's say from 10 kilo to 21 kilo, you're charged this much. And if it's heavier, you charge them $50. Let's continue. Alright, as you can see, our first shipping rate has been configured and we already have one of our products matching it right here. Let's go ahead and create a few more. Let's create a new shipping rate for our large quantity orders. So let's click plus again, filter products by large quantity orders. There we go. Large quantity order, and here under the shipping rate table we'll be using number of items. Let's say the number of items from 1 to 100 you pay a certain amount, let's say $10, and when you order more than that, 101 items and more, you get a bit of a discount. Let's give it $5. Okay, we're done. Let's continue. Let's add one more. The next one we're looking at is large price product. So let's look at large There we go, large price order. Once you've done that, here we're looking at the order price. So let's go ahead and click that. Let's say from $1 to $1,000, you are charging them $10. But if you're ordering anything more than $1,000, we're going to give them a discount, and let's say it is $5 instead. Let's go continue. Last but not the least, we have something for remote destination. So let's go filter products by remote destination. This is exactly what you're looking for. Let's give it a name, remote destination. And under the shipping rates, we're looking at destination. So let's click on that. Let's say destination by state. Right now, let's say for our destination, if we choose Alabama and it's a bit distant from us, we consider that a remote location. For that, let's charge a higher price. Let's say we're gonna charge $30 instead. Let's go and hit continue. Voila, as you can see, we have all our different products set up with the different shipping rates right here. So right now, when you're ordering a product and it's matching any of these shipping rates, you will get those prices accordingly. There you go, guys. Now you know how you can configure your shipping attributes inside Google Merchant Center. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.